Welcome to the latest edition of the Wrestle Ropes Podcast. I remembered it this time. With your host, as always, Billy. This is, of course, the Wrestle Ropes Podcast, is where we preview a show or we review a show. It's a focus podcast, which is something that doesn't happen with any other podcast I do. On this edition, you've probably seen the title already. We're going to speak about this weekend's, as of release, Source Wrestling Resurgence, which is taking place at Source Wrestling School on the 18th of February. And 19th of February. I've got my glasses on. Still can't read the things on my screen here. I am joined on this preview, though. Always got a co-host because you never want to hear my voice just with nothing else. It's terrible. By one of the co-owners of Source Wrestling, fellow wrestler. I'm not a wrestler. He's a wrestler. Always goes well. It's Robbie Wishart. Welcome to the show.
Yay, I'm back. Yay. Thank you for having me. I have been so excited for this. I cannot wait.
That's what I like. I like people coming back and actually being excited to be here. So that's always good. We shouldn't go 2 hours like we did last time, but you know, the night is young. Exactly. We get the first match in, and then that's us for till 9 o'clock. As again, we're recording like 7 as always when I'm doing these. But yeah, we're speaking about Source Wrestling Resurgence. But how are you? How's it going?
I'm good. Yeah, I'm off the tail end of a cold, hence why I'm a bit sniffly, but yeah, I'm good. Well, as good as I can be. I've had to make a wee announcement that I'm stepping back for the ring, but I'm excited because now I get to focus on a side of wrestling I've always wanted to be really involved in, and that's promoting and booking a shows, which is what I've came on to do with Source. But yeah.
I remember you saying last time when we had a chat, I didn't listen to it, so this is all just off the top of my head because I don't like the sound of my own voice. But I remember you saying that promoting was something that you were really passionate about, and that was something you're really going to focus on. So it's just kind of, it's come to a head now where you've just decided to one or other. Come then. You did say that you don't want to go too much in detail, so I'll respect that and not do so. So we won't go too much into the whole retirement thing, but we'll speak about it a little bit more when we get to the match, your last match, the Source Wrestling Ring, at least for now, because you know it's wrestling. It's never a proper retirement. It's always a until next time, but the next time might be a little bit longer than usual.
Like at the time, I didn't want to go into too much detail because I wasn't really sure what was happening yet. It very much became a from the initial checkup to the end of the week. A lot of things happened quite quickly. So yeah, I'm comfortable talking about it, but I'm gonna wait till after the podcast if you don't mind, because I'm gonna do a video myself explaining what's happening and why I'm taking a step back. But
that's no bother at all. That's fine. Of course, we'll share it when it goes out as we do through SWN. Anyway, let's speak about happier things. So last year, December, of course, well, 2020 was kind of a write off. March 2020 was the last show for Source for that year. It looked like it was going to be a 2021 of nothing as well, but. Hit my microphone there. But Source Wrestling returned 17th of December 2021. How did it feel? I mean, by looking at the results, you're the first match out. So how did it feel just getting back, getting Source Wrestling back in front of a crowd?
It was chaotic. We originally weren't going to run a show, to be honest. We were actually going to hold off till this weekend. As of this release, we were going to hold off to that weekend to the first show. But because of how well our trainees did and how much they stuck wise and they still showed support despite all the massive changes and the fact that we were the only company not really running during that time, we just thought, no, this show isn't for us, it's for them. It's to show them that we are thankful for how much support they've given us. And when we made the first announcement of the show to when we had the actual crowd in the venue, like, it was insane. It's not a big venue, Source. It's not the Hydro. Let's not lie about that. But the people that came in,
passionate crowd. It's a passionate crowd. Small numbers.
Yeah, like they were there. They supported what we did, and considering it was literally less than a week before Christmas, it was amazing how many people turned up. I was surprised that we sold out. We did, in fact, sell out. And it was just good. It was great. It was a great atmosphere. I myself in the first match, because I wanted to be able, as soon as my match was over, to kind of keep an eye on and watch everyone that's going on. But the crowd was so energetic. Like, Luke Matthews went out, who I wrestled with that night. He walked out, was the first person they seen, and he was practically in tears because it felt so good to be in front of him. Like, genuinely good moment. It almost got me crying, and I was like, oh, I need to beat you up now.
One of those things, I mean, I've said it in our podcast, but I didn't realise how much I missed it until I went to a show. I went to WrestleZone Halloween Hijinks, my first show back, so it was the October, and I didn't believe it. I thought, oh, you know, I've done all these things on the site and everything. I've kept myself active in the wrestling community, or at least with my brain worrying about Scottish wrestling. And then actually seeing it live again and seeing the first person come out, I was like, oh, God, I've missed this so much. I'm 31, and I've missed watching guys rumble about in their pants. This is a thing I've missed so much because of this pandemic. And it's, it would have been at that show as well all the wrestlers coming out, but seeing the wrestlers come out and just seeing a crowd, it was quite heartwarming to see that they kind of, you guys missed us as well as we missed you.
It was so dead. Like, it wasn't so bad for me because I worked the respect show like maybe the month before or something, so it wasn't like my first show back, but for a lot of the Source guys, it was their first show back. We had Cassie King debut that show for Source. And she was just overwhelmed. Plus, we had other debuts for that show, like Stone Malone, Hal Rayner. Like, they were just, it was just such a good feeling, like, for everyone. Even ADM, who's usually, like, quite broody and moody and just hating everybody, he was genuinely quite passionate that night. It was great.
It's weird. Now we've got this kind of lay of the land thing after everything that's happened in the past. It's interesting to see this kind of mix of talent now. Popping up in places, because I mean, not that there's any kind of territory or any of that rubbish, but you wouldn't expect to see certain talents from some places pop up in some places, even though this supposed territory thing's gone. But to see guys like your Hal Rayner and Stone Malone pop up in Source, you think, well, that might not have happened 2 years back. It never happened. But no, we're in a position now where anyone can appear anywhere. So it's always exciting, yeah. Especially the matches that could be announced.
I'm of the opinion, so I was, like, when I came through, there was lots of people only had certain guys, and very few people would travel certain places. Like, Falcon, he was one of the few people who I remember going from different promotion. It was always a surprise to see him, whereas we're in a day and age now where, like, there's such good talent from everywhere. Why shouldn't we see them pop up? So why shouldn't you see Stone Moon up against ADM like we did that show, or... why wouldn't Hal Rayner suddenly appear and take a microphone and demand a match? Heck, like, the big one for the next show is Lucha DS is finally in a Source ring. You have no idea how hard I have pushed for that.
Yeah, I'm not surprised, considering, of course, a little history with Lucha Scotland as well. I'm surprised it's taken this kind of long to possibly have him there. Well, this would have been your first. Was this your first proper show that you would have promoted or co-promoted then, yes. Since taking over Source? So yes. What did you find out? What was the things that you've kind of realised that, I'm going to have to remember this next show, and how did it all go together? Did you kind of cope?
There were silly little things, like having a guy who's solely there to do music is a good idea. remember memory cards for the cameras is another good lesson. Which, yeah, that whole show was meant to be recorded and we forgot the memory cards for the cameras and we didn't, which is a shame because some of the matches were amazing. Like the main event between Dead and Blair and Grant MacIver, I think it's probably one of the best matches Source has ever produced, and yet the only person that's getting any footage of it is Dead, and it's because his dad filmed it.
Little things.
Yeah.
So the memory cards have all been bought in bulk, ready for this weekend.
one better, hire a professional cameraman to do it, who's bringing his own equipment. The man who films Reckless's stuff, which is always really high quality, he's come in to film both days of the weekend, and we'll be releasing, as soon as it's ready, we'll be releasing the main event of night one, so everyone can see who goes, can have a surprise on who goes to challenge Grant McIver the next night, which I'm so buzzing for that match.
Yeah, looking at it, we'll get into it a little bit, but yeah, the matches have been announced, even though there are a few, again, we'll get into that, that there is certainly some, it's worth, I mean, what is it, a fiver to get in, something like that? For £5, I mean, the matches that have been announced already, tenner for the weekend, and you get guaranteed to at least see six high quality matches that will, again, we'll get into it. But so just to finish off the bit about December then, Source Wrestling returned, and the results are on the website, on our website, swnscotland.com. I think that's the only place, because I think I tapped you for them, or tapped someone in Source for them.
I think I sent you them almost immediately as soon as the show was done.
That's fine. That's what I like. I don't like chasing for results. It's just, I always feel awkward doing it, especially if it's the only reason I message people. It's like, can I get results now? Can I get results now, please?
I don't get why people don't use like yourself and your website for it, because people are going to, people sit and look at it. Like, I'm a bit of an egotist, but see, whenever I see you share like the Source logo and it goes match confirmed, I'm gonna check this, even though I know what it's been announced, just because I'm like a platform to use.
Thank God you did, because I had the date wrong in the first one. I had December, because I just copied the last result. I just edited it as I need to, and I totally missed it. And I was like, oh God, you checked, because I would have realized the second match announcement. Anyone reading the first one would have been like, oh, the show's happening in December. no, it's not. But no, thank God people proofread these things. I don't, clearly. I just kind of hope for the best. I found out how to do it on my phone quite quickly, which is always a blessing. It's either really good, so I get the information out straight away, or really bad because I put the dates wrong and it just goes all to pot. Here's me trying not to swear on my own podcast, because this is a family show and families are going to come along to this for, again, £10 for a weekend.
Just £10 for a confirmed 14 matches, but I'm only announced six.
And we're going to get into them. Last bit about that, again, last bit about December, was Grant McIver, of course, retained the Source Wrestling Championship. I think he's now on, what, 1,000 days or something like that,
as champion. As he continues to remind me with every message about his championship reign.
Like, he just puts a message, and at the end he puts Grant McIver, 1,000 and whatever days as Source Wrestling champion. So let's get into the show then. So like we said, Resurgence, Source Wrestling Resurgence, taking place on Friday the 18th of February, Saturday the 19th of February, at the Source Wrestling School, that's 22 Coogan Street in Glasgow. £5 at the door per night. Absolute bargain. Resurgence, though. So was there any reason for the name? Is just because it's the first show of the new year? What was your kind of thoughts behind that?
Because it was meant to be the first show's back. It was meant to be before we did Source Returns. And I like the name because it's now continues that, because it's not just, oh, it's the first show of the year. This is the first shows of the new version of Source, because my version of Source is going to be different from the previous owners. Still very much similar, but it's going to be the start of, as cocky as it sounds, the Wishart era of Source Wrestling. It's going to be what my image of Source should be. It's bringing in talent you wouldn't necessarily see, like a Lucha DS and a Stone Malone and a Hal Rayner. I've already in talks to bring in some English talent in as well for some shows down the line. It's about creating a new version of Source that everyone can enjoy, not just your diehard wrestling fans, but the family that have decided to have a night out. That's what it is. So it's the resurgence of Source and basically the start of my new version.
So, I mean, Source Wrestling, obviously, in my mind anyway, was kind of just, it was a wrestling show. So it was really good wrestling, and not so much, there was obviously some characters, you had your Zeros and what have you, but it was really a wrestling show. By the sounds of it, with like, so bringing in your Lucha DS and what have you, you're kind of put a little bit of colour in there, kind of thing. Maybe a bit more variety show.
Yeah, we're pro wrestlers, but we're also entertainers. Like, I don't know where everyone, like, I could sit and watch a full 3 hours of a wrestling show, but somebody's dad might not be able to. So, like, let's give them something they can enjoy. Let's have your silly, fun matches that'll make you laugh, to then followed up by maybe one of those matches that the super fans would love. Like, for example, Darren versus Grant McIver was an indie wrestling superfest, whereas from that December show, ADM and Stone Malone came out dressed as Santa each and had an arm wrestling contest. Crowd loved it, and it's just all about having that bit of personality again.
Yeah, wrestling
needs to be fun as well as serious, so let's have that fun.
Absolutely. I mean, at the end of the day, I mean, the best way you can put it is wrestling's a circus. So you can enjoy the I don't know, I'm trying to think of a serious one, and you can try the acrobats.
Mm.
Yeah, we'll go with that. So you can enjoy the acrobats, but not everyone necessarily wants to see 3 hours of acrobats. They want a clown.
Yeah.
They want a lion tamer. They want, what else? I don't know what else happens at the circus. Because
Lion tamers, ballerinas, there's all these kind of things that happens at circus. It's not always going to be this one thing, and I think wrestling should be. I mean, we started from the carnivals, so why not continue that theme? Let's just embrace that some people aren't going to care about how well you can reverse a wrestler, but some people are going to remember the guy that made them laugh. And that's what wrestling needs to be.
And that's what gets people back. Because I know from my own experience, with my family, I take them to like really local shows, so like Bucky or Keith or something, like up in the Northeast. And the only reason my dad would come back was because one wrestler who would come out and would just kind of lampoon the whole thing of wrestling and just kind of not take the mick of it, but like just kind of commentate during the matches of his own work. And my dad would sit there just chuckling away and find it hilarious. And then next time I'd go, oh, I've got a show. There's a show coming up here. He goes, oh, are they there? I'll come along. I'll take the grandkids and all that kind of stuff. I'll take them. They'll be fine. So you know, get your tickets back. Get your tickets sold.
Yeah.
whereas I'll take anything if it's within 50 miles of me. I'll probably go. That's pretty much my remit for wrestling, because I'm just a massive nerd for this stuff. Anyway,
me too.
So Resurgence Night One. We'll start with. Which is always a good place to start when it comes to this. Don't start at night two. So we've got three matches announced for that show. One being, you've kind of alluded to, or you've alluded to most of these already, but we'll start with Colton Davis and Lucha DS. So yeah. Lucha is making his long-awaited, long-anticipated, long-wanted debut in Source Wrestling, and you've put him in with Colton Davis. What was your kind of thoughts putting this kind of clash of styles together?
So, I've wrestled both men. I've wrestled Lucha, I think, the second most times of any person I've wrestled, aside the other one being Dickie Divers, randomly. But Lucha is one of those rare talents that his personality carries him everywhere, but he's just as capable in the ring. So he'll go out, he'll entertain that crowd, and he'll still be able to perform. Whereas Colton Davis is 6'6" at 18 years old and has got so much potential, but a massive, massive ego, to the point he claims he's undefeated, but the fact is never won a match. Yeah, he asked for a tight match.
Oh, all right, okay. So you didn't want to put him in the main event, the four-way now?
No, when he came up to me and went, because I'm undefeated, I think I should wrestle Grant McIver. And I went, I've beaten you, what are you talking about? He went, no, you didn't. He just blatantly denied that he's ever lost. But I think this is a great test for Colton. Lucha has been on the top of his game. He always has been. So I think putting Colton, who is also quite athletic, in with someone who will make him out, will take him out of his comfort zone just because of how, not silly, but how larger than life he is. I think that'll force Colton to realise that just because you're 6'6" doesn't necessarily mean that you are entitled to everything.
I don't know what you guys are feeding them at Source, but you've got a lot of tall dudes, a lot of big guys there at Source. And yeah, Colton's definitely one of them. Richard, yes, when you're going about, you say he's experienced, he's on quite a roll. I don't think there's a show now where if he's got the weekend free, Lucha will be wrestling every single weekend. I think he'd wrestle every day if he could. But he does quite every so often message me, going, is there any shows going on this weekend that you know of nearby? And I'll just go, I don't know. I'll check my calendar. I think here's got a show. Ah, cool. And then you'll pop up there. You'll end up either in the crowd or wrestling on it. He just wants to wrestle.
Yeah.
It's just amazing.
His logic is why I want him, because he's a great person to have backstage. Wrestling's fun to him. Like, if it wasn't fun, he wouldn't do it. So just having him there, and then he's a bit of a joker, but he has a laugh. And if he thinks he's going to enjoy it, then there's a good chance the crowd's going to enjoy it. So that's why he just goes out. And I was so desperate to have that kind of personality backstage, because he's just a good person to be around. He's a great presence. Like, he just lifts up that atmosphere.
And of course, you can't go wrong with a family show. A masked wrestler never fails to at least get the kids involved at the very least, because you know, masks are just the best. I mean, through the last show I went to, I ended up buying a mask because, you know, again, nerd. But no, I ended up coming home with a Spider-Man mask because I was like, I need it. It's just, masks are cool.
His Spider-Man mask, like, every time he wears it, I see it up close and I go, God, that's so cool.
Sitting there, in your drawer of Solar gear going, I don't have a Spider-Man one, though. You had a green Power Ranger. That was cool.
I've still got it. It's my prized possession. I can mention this now because I probably will never get made. I had a Venom set made team with Lucha, so I was getting the mask and gear and all that made, and the idea was he's Spider-Man and then I'm Venom, because I thought that was a really cool dynamic, and then like we just stopped really teaming. I was like, if we ever wrestle, maybe.
That would be cool. And now I'm just thinking of all, like, masks are just cool. I mean, even to the point where I now got a mask tattooed.
Oh, so cool.
I call it my Iron Brucha because it's Iron Brew colors and all that kind of stuff. But wrestling, masks, just, yeah, it's the best. So yeah, Colin Davis, Lucha DS, Clash of Styles, like we've said, but Lucha brings us all wealth of experience, so it's going to be definitely one that be just someone that people are going to love seeing. Colton Davis, I'll do a cheap plug. I've interviewed both these guys, so you can go into the archives of the SWM podcast. Got them both, along with just about everyone else on this card. But yeah, we talked to a lot of people. The second match, we'll go for the four way because we'll end on your match. I think that's probably the best way to do that, seeing as you're my guest. We've got the four way winner faces Grant McIver for the Source Wrestling Championship on night two. Is this just a straight up fatal four way elimination?
Yes, no? Straight up fatal four way, no elimination. First fall to the finish. Dalen Hendry versus Alexander Darwin McCallan. Yes, I was able to say his name. It took me so many times to get that right. Source Wrestling legend Glenn Dunbar, and of course Griffin.
Yeah, especially with the Alexander Darwin McCallan. I got to a point where I kept spelling his name wrong so many times, he just messaged me and went, just put ADM. Just put ADM. And then I got stubborn and I was like, no, I can spell this. I can do this right every time. Don't you worry. Alexander Darwin McCallan. Of course, in this match, he is the former Source Wrestling champion. He was the first.
We've
only had two Source Wrestling champions. I've just realized now.
Yes, there's only ever been two Source Wrestling champions. ADM was the first. He defeated Mike Burg, on the tournament final. Held it to a Govan show. I can't remember how long ago this was, previous management, so apologies, ADM. And lost it in a fatal four-way to Grant McIver. He has never had his one-on-one rematch, but since it's been so long since he's been near the championship, I don't feel quite right just handing him the opportunity. Hence why I decided to make the four-way. So the former champion who's never... I'm also pretty sure he never was pinned. I'm pretty sure he never actually lost the championship.
Yeah, his legs were tied up. I think I don't know if there's some. I think don't know if it was the work of Men's Club or somebody, or maybe MacIver himself. They taped his legs to the ring post, if I remember rightly.
Yeah, so he was not actually pinned. So I feel basically what I've done is everyone in the four way hasn't had a chance to prove why they should be in this match to me, be it if I've just went through their history of what they did in Source, or if it's just through my own personal beliefs. And ADM, I feel justifiably so, should have an opportunity to earn his one-on-one rematch for the championship that he never rightfully lost.
So yeah, ADM in there, again, former champion, as we said. Glenn Dunbar, you can say the legend of Source Wrestling, and our guy who's just wrestled just about everywhere at some point as well, returning to Source. Of course, last time out, of course, he was one half of, I don't know if this was official team name, but this is what you told me, that 80s guys, which as soon as you typed out, I was like, yes, that's
important. I said it to him, he laughed, Tom Fulton just looked at me and went, okay. But I think that's most of the conversations I had. Like, again, I don't really need to justify Glenn Dunbar. We call him the Source Wrestling legend because he is legitimately a legend to Source Wrestling. As soon as it came to make this match, I had to think about justifying it to them. As soon as I saw Dunbar was active again, I was like, nope, he's going straight in it.
One that's a little bit different, not so much out there, but a guy who's kind of been on the fringes of Source, being involved in some good matches, some good wrestling matches as well, is Dalen Hendry, who is maybe, I would say, the dark horse, possibly, in this four-way coming in.
So, I've wrestled Dalen in a championship match before. I defended the Respect Pro Wrestling Championship against him. And obviously, I came out on top in that scenario, but there's something there. He's one moment away from not just being the dark horse, but there's something about him. Just he's got a determination he didn't have before. I don't know where it's come from, but The last show, Source Wrestling Returned, he lost to Griffin 1-on-1. And instead of just licking his wounds and walking backstage and going, oh, well, I had fun, he came back and he kept saying, I can do better. I will do better next time. And he just had this look of, I can be better. And I just intrigued me. So yeah, he might be a dark horse, but I wouldn't maybe count him out just yet.
Well, guys like Dalen as well, I mean, this has been just about 2 years of their hopes and of a career gone, and when you're coming back to wrestle and you don't do as well as you hope to do, or if you don't get the win, or you don't perform, and that's again another kind of notch off another, that's just your bump card filled a little bit more with nothing to show for it. So it's, yeah, if you're coming in with that intensity going, no, I'm going to be absolute best I can be, and he's out there to obviously prove himself.
Yeah, so that look instantly when I mentioned the four-way, I got a message from right away going, what do I need to do to be in that four-way? And he's like, I told him what he needed to do. Every week he was in training. Every week he was at CrossFit. Every day, and then I watched him wrestle one day, and I went, "You're in the four-way," and that was it. Because he's hungry. It's good. It's exciting. It's nice to see. I really want him to do well, and I want him to. Oh, I know he can. So I'm just excited to see how he does in this scenario.
And of course, last but not no means least, we've got Griffin, who might not be a favourite of a lot of people's, just because of his actions in Source Wrestling, and of course with Anthina as well. But I mean, just from skill. I mean, this guy's a former, of course, SWA junior heavyweight champion. He knows his way around gold. He's done well for himself, and he's kind of still getting this new attitude together. And
yeah,
I don't know if Anthony's going to be there, but surely he's going to at least have a little bit of a numbers advantage if she is, and fatal four way, so there's no disqualification. It's just going to be a fight to the finish.
I mean,
anyone could win this, obviously, with all the names are in here, but I think Griffin's got kind of maybe unless Dalen's this new intense mindset has got him kind of like a spider sense of everything around him. But I think Griffin's just sneaky enough, maybe just to kind of just find a way.
I remember flying Ryan Griffin, and that was a 180 to what he is now. But he's another one. He's leaner. He's a lot of people don't know. He was seriously injured before he came back. Like in general, he had a severe back injury. Now he's back. He's wrestling. He's got his muscle in Athena, who is probably one of the most powerful people I've ever met. Not women, people, because there are men that aren't as strong as her. And he's just this cocky confidence. God, I hate him, but God, I enjoy it. Like, he just, I'm like, oh, you shut up. But yeah, you're in the four-way. Of course, I'll put you in the four-way because he's of all the talent Source produced, he's always been one of the ones that people kind of forgot about. And you're like, but anyone who's wrestled him said the words, no, Griffin's one of the best. I mean, I'm not just saying this, but some of the people I've been in the ring with, bear in mind, I've plugged it many times. I've been in the ring with Will Ospreay, Jonathan Gresham, Speedball Mike Bailey. There's a top talent in Scotland that I've been around him, and I don't think half of them are as good as Griffin is.
Certainly, yeah, he definitely, regardless of his attitude and how he kind of comes out in his character, he's certainly one of just the best in the ring. So it's definitely coming out of Source. So again, there is. You literally, if we look at this four way, I don't think you could pick a winner. It would literally be going randomly. Well, I think it's going to be that guy, because all of them have the chops, have the creed.
There isn't one that definitely could win. There isn't one that you would be surprised. You wouldn't be surprised if any of them won, but you wouldn't be surprised if any of them lost either, because just the field is so strong. As I said, the legend in Dunbar. He'll somehow pull out a trick that no one's seen for the better part of 20 years to win. ADM never lost the championship, never anger a man like the Clyde River Killer. Dalen, whoever's lit a fire under him, I hope to God he continues, and I hope it leads to much bigger things in the future for him. And then Griffin, if he wasn't so egotistical, I'd put my money on Griffin.
That we'll definitely find out on Friday. And like you say, once as soon as the footage is received, edited, what have you, we'll be out.
Yeah, we'll be
and hopefully we'll see it before Saturday, and we'll know who's going to be facing Grant McIver on that second night. We don't really speak about that match itself, but we will in the next bit for the second show, because I think Grant would be very miffed if we didn't at least mention him.
He's mentioned me at least twice since this interview has started, I guarantee it.
Of course, yeah. I mean, it's adding hours to his reign here as we're going through here. So the last match I've got announced for the show is, of course, it's your final match in a Source Wrestling ring, at least for the as far as we're aware, as far as we know, for the foreseeable future, against Deren J. Blair. So, like I said, Deren, you've already kind of hyped him up because he had this amazing match with Grant McIver, unfortunately. Only people at Source Wrestling in the crowd and at the show will know how amazing this match will be. But maybe one day we'll get a rematch in the future. But so this is your last match in Source Wrestling ring. I think you got respect by the end of the month for the Interpromotional Championship against Akiba Lee. But why Deren? Why was Deren the guy that you had to get in the ring with in the last time in Source?
So, I apologize, I'll probably get quite emotional about this. There's four trainees in the source that I could have chose from. Any one of them could have done. Colton Davis is one of them. AJ Diaz and Jack Ripley, Wishart, the other two, and then there's Darren. I chose Darren because Darren does a lot of the graphic work for Source. That's who does these incredible graphics for us, and I'm not blowing smoke up the boys' backside, but they're all really good, high quality. When it came to the first show, I went to pay him, and he says, "I don't want payment for it." And I'm like, "Well, you've got to do something because you did such incredible graphics. What do you want?" And he asked for a match with me. Now, I, at the time, didn't know what would happen, obviously, and then I promised him that match because, yeah, if that's what you want, cool, you can have that match. And now, bittersweetly, it will be my last match in a Source Wrestling ring. And if I'm going to go out in a last match with someone, I want it to be with someone who I think could carry wrestling while I'm gone. And Darren is only 18 years old. He has his full wrestling career ahead of him. So if I can, in my last match, just have this one opportunity to show Darren what I expect he'll be able to accomplish in the future, then I'll drag him to one of the best matches he will ever have, because that's what I've always done. I've always believed, and some people may call me out on this, some people may say, you're just saying that. I've always believed I'm one of the best in this country. It's a pretty arrogant claim to make, I'm fully aware of that, but before me, there wasn't cruiserweights. Before me, your zero-G champion was Noam Dar, who didn't wrestle like a cruiserweight, was Wolfgang, who was a heavyweight playing whatever he wanted to do, because Wolfgang's a freak of nature and can do whatever he wants to do. I came in and held with some of the best this country will ever produce for nearly 10 years, and in 10 years I have gotten to the point I am comfortable to say I am one of the best. People may not like me. I'm fully aware of people don't like me. I've made plenty of enemies over wrestling, but they will never deny what I am capable of in the ring, and that is what I intend to show. I've been Scotland's greatest luchador solar for however many years, and when I step foot in that ring with Darren, Darren's going to understand what that means to me, because that boy's going to have main events for years to come, but this might be my last opportunity to have a match like this. I'm not going to be able to relive my glory days and fight Osprey or Gresham or Speedball or the Coffees or anything like that again. So Darren's going to understand what this means to me, whether he likes it or not, and if it means he can't beat me because he's not ready yet, good. It just gives him something to strive to be better for. And then if he does beat me, it means he's ready to carry on what I believe Source needs to be, and I can retire happily.
Oh, yeah, so this is going to be quite... We spoke about the intensity of Bayland. You're coming in here with just... fire.
Yeah. Like, then Darren's one of the ones I want to see do well, but I will be damned if I lie down for him without making sure he knows what he has to do to be one of the best.
I'm definitely if it turns out to be a passing of the torch, this is a guy that you're like, he's going to learn. He's going to learn what it is going to be to carry a company, whether he wants to or not, in this match itself. Goes through it. So I mean, you got that. You've got, like I say, you've got bringing guys like Lucha in to be there well for this match as well. It's like you're bringing a little bit of your family, Source family, your outside, your Lucha Scotland family, your British wrestling family. It's all kind of, they're going to be around about this show to see this, and hopefully this will be one more match that'll end up on whatever YouTube. Vimeo, Daily Motion. I don't know what gets used nowadays. Some still YouTube. Yeah. But no, this will be definitely a. It's going to be an emotional affair. But I think I'm fair to say that.
Yeah. Lucha has walked me down to the ring. One of my best mates in wrestling, Bobby Roberts, is going to be in the crowd. My son will be there because I don't want him to see that. But when I'm older, and if he ever chooses to want to be a wrestler, I'll show him this and go, this is what I did with wrestling. It's up to you if you want to continue it or not. But one of the other things is this last match will be something I'll be proud of, and I'll be showing it till eventually I can come back. Or if I don't, then it's something to be proud of. Just Darren now needs to keep up.
So yeah, Darren's gonna definitely need to do all his stamina and cardio. Definitely this week as we roll towards Resurgence as well. Yeah, Darren's a guy. Of course, he had the match with Grant as we've discussed already at length. So even though he didn't quite get the win, like you've said, it was an incredible match. So he's hoping to kind of build upon that, whether it's pinning you or just putting another incredible showing in. We won't know until Friday, of course. But it's definitely going to be, definitely going to be an emotional contest for whatever reason. Even if it's going to end the night, both of you with whelps upon your chest and whatever else. It's going to be a fight. If it's not going to be the greatest hits, it's definitely going to be a fight for absolute certain. So that's the match they've got announced for night one. I don't know if there's anything else you can.
Now I'm less emotional. Yeah, I can confirm that KOE will be in action on night one, taking on Airstrike. So we're going to have another top tag team going, showing the young boys what to do, because that's basically what KOE are, the top tag team in this country, and I firmly believe that. And I've said that to them multiple times. But Airstrike, they're young, they're eager to learn, so why not put them in with the best team to learn? They will be in action. I can confirm Luke Matthews will be in action as well. He will be going one-on-one with Manlin, making his grand return to Source Wrestling.
Hey, Manlin. He's always Luke Matthews, and our fantastic talent. KOE, of course, Airstrike. I don't know the names in front of me. I'm going to feel so bad. It's AJ Diaz and... who's that one again? Sorry. Sorry, guys.
AJ Diaz and Jack Ripley.
I thought it was Jack Ripley. I had Ripley in my head and I thought, is it Ripley? But sorry, Jack. Yeah, it's Jack Ripley. So that's your four the kind of pillars that you kind of not that you've put
the four pillars that helped build. Does that make sense?
Yeah, so you've got Colton. You've got Darren, you've got AJ, and you've got Jack. So these are your four guys. Like I said, anyone could have been your last match. These are your four guys you've got on the show. So the crowd will be introduced again, because they were on shows before lockdown. Yeah. But they're going to get introduced to this new crop of Source Wrestling talent coming through. KOE, of course, the unofficial Source, with an S, two S's, tag team champions, making their way back. The Source Wrestling, they've been doing okay with themselves. They've popped up on the old WWE network, and
they are in phenomenal shape right now. Like when I not to brag, but I've always kind of been in shape. But when King Killer took his top off at the last show backstage, I went, "I'll just put mine back on, will I?" Man is in incredible shape. He's like, again, not people know this, but they are actually brothers in real life. But Kai William King is exactly, he's so shredded now. As like, have you two done during lockdown?
No, it seems to be lockdown's done two things to quite, not every wrestler, but most. Either they come out shredded or they come out quite a bit bigger with the intention to lean it out. And it might not happen. But yeah, so there's two ways. Nobody's come out of lockdown the exact same shape. It's always, yeah, bigger or ripped in some sort of way. So shredded or shredded chicken. It's one of the two. That's what's been the week, the 2 months has been, two years has been. As well, so KOE, I'll be keeping an eye on them on WWE Network and for ICW, of course. So I'll be interested to see what they've got, what they've learned in that time, because of course they're wrestling in front of nobody, and then people, and then possibly nobody again, and they're coming in with a full strength Source Wrestling crowd who are come to see Source Wrestling in all its glory. For one night, or two, if they put down the extra £5, surely you're going to put down the extra five or see our night of wrestling. Luke Matthews and Manlin, was there a match you mentioned? Of course, I do love Manlin. He's just, I don't know whether he's still homeless Manlin or if he's got the pennies together from his Twitch streams to no longer be homeless Manlin. But this is your Source Wrestling match. The rest of them, they've got Source Wrestlers, they're putting a little bit of spin on things, but Luke Matthews, Manlin, this is your kind of epitome, I would say, of a Source Wrestling.
This is probably as old school as Source as it could be. Like, again, Manlin's been around for years, a lot of people don't realise that, but he's always been consistently good talent at Source, despite being homeless. And then Luke Matthews, one of the top strikers in the country. Like, I wrestled him at December. I won. But he's probably, if he's not the top striker in the country, he's definitely one of. And he's only gotten better. So I can't wait to see how that goes down. He may kick Manlin into dust. Manlin may chop him into dust. Because I don't know if people know this, but Manlin's chops are some of the most vicious things I've ever felt in my life. To a point I actively avoid them.
Five matches for first night that you can confirm. Of course, there's going to be some surprises on the night, I'm sure. It's not going to be a foregone conclusion. So if you listen to this and thinking those five matches sounds great, there's probably going to be a sixth one. It's going to be amazing. So it's, again, I'm going to keep saying it. It's £5. I like going to wrestling. I paid what, £10-15 a ticket, and it's great. I love it. But £5, you can't say no to that, surely, if you're in the area or if you're within a transport system away to get there. Just to recap the matches then. So Colton Davis versus Lucha DS, Robert Wishart versus Darren J. Blair. We've got KOE versus Airstrike in a tag team match. Luke Matthews and Manlin going at it. And of course, the main event, again, I assume it's the main event just because of the implication it has. The four-way to crown the number one contender for the night two, Alexander Darwin McCallum, I got it right again, versus Glenn DeBar, Dalen Hendry, and Griffin in a four-way. Get £5, doors open 6:30 at Source Wrestling School in Coogan Street, bell time 7 p.m, tickets available at the door. Like I said, recapping that, absolute bargain for anyone that's wanting to just get see some wrestling, because nothing, if you've listened to this for some however reason, you're onto this and you've never watched wrestling, never went to a wrestling show, I don't know how you're still here. But again, £5, kids will love it, adults will love it, you don't think you will, but you will, because it's just, this is some of the best nights of wrestling, best nights in general you'll ever have. In my opinion, even though I do say that as someone who's watched wrestling since I was like 8 years old, so of course I will say it's the best night. But trust me, I've got a trustable face. Thank you. So that's night one. We've a little bit of emotion. Had a bit of I think we've had a full range of emotions, and just that recap of night one in itself. Night two it's going to be another absolutely incredible night. Again, we've got three matches confirmed, and I'm sure we're going to get a scoop or two out of you there for that, but we'll get onto it. So Saturday, 19th of February, again, doors 6:30, first bell, £7, £5. So again, I'm just stressing this to people, £5. So yeah, we've already mentioned the Source Wrestling Championship. We'll get into that in a little bit because, you know, again, Grant McIver, as he's got 10 messages unread to you, just making sure that you mention his name several times during this. We'll get on to it. But we'll start off with a guy that you mentioned, who I think did make his debut at Return, Stone Malone.
Yes, against
Taylor Veit.
Yes.
Again, another clash of styles here. Stone Malone, big powered guy. He's just going to batter you, throw you about if he can, and because he is inevitable. And then Taylor Veit, the smartest wrestler in Scottish wrestling, British wrestling. I don't know if he's conquered the world yet, but he's certainly got a strategy or two. What I'm getting from you, from what our discussions in the past and this, you love a styles clash.
I do. I really do. So styles makes fights is one of my favourite quotes ever. And like everyone uses it to describe different fighting sports and all that stuff. Like, don't get me wrong, when you see two of the top like high flyers go in the ring, you're like, oh, this is going to be amazing. Craig Anfey versus Daz Black's a perfect example of that. But I don't know, watching a big, powerful guy like Stone Malone, who can, as you say, throw people around and manhandle and stuff, watching him go one-on-one with someone who will be faster than Arnold, but won't try high flying, will try to submission him, will try to break him down, will pick a body part, he'll pick probably six different body parts, knowing Taylor, and he'll try and wear him down gradually. Stuff like that I enjoy. Especially with someone who's so good at holds and joint manipulation like Taylor, who I can watch Taylor Veit break a man down all day, in the same way I can watch Stone Malone throw a man around all day.
It's a tactical game, as obviously it's a tactician, Taylor Veit. But yeah, it's always fun to watch a wrestler try to chop down the big redwood and just work their way down as slowly as possible, or as articulated, that's not the word, I don't know, but you know what I mean, everyone knows what I mean. But yeah, just do it in such a way where you just slowly break them at one limb by limb. So Stone, of course, coming in from a place where it's a bit more, I don't know, entertainment-y, but he made his debut against ADM. I'm not trusting myself to say his full name again. I already nailed it twice. I think I'm quite happy just to leave it with ADM. So he came in against ADM, big guy, kind of similar in his kind of mindset, just throw and kick and punch and just demolish. And I was coming in with a guy that's the absolute opposite of ADM, I would say. Maybe similar when it comes to cerebralness, but certainly different in terms of as we're saying, style. This is gonna be something. It just depends if Stone can grab Taylor. That's going to be the difference in this match, I think.
If Stone can hit the discus lariat, because the first thing I ever noticed about Stone was his discus lariat was brutal. Like, he could easily win most matches with it. And when I mentioned it to him, he started incorporating it a lot more. And I've been on a receiving one myself with padding, and it bruised my chest because of how hard he hit me. And I was like, oh, good God. So if he hits Taylor, that Taylor is done.
But then again, Taylor's a fit lad. He's one of these guys that's got himself ripped. Like myself, I said, you're a shredded or shred chicken. I've definitely ate my fair share of shredded chicken during lockdown. But so you're going to have to hope those muscles aren't just for show if he's going to survive.
it'll be a very interesting contest. Again, styles makes fights. Stuff like that intrigues me. Like, so I'll be watching gleefully as they go out, and knowing I won't have to do anything that night because I'll be retired from the Source Ring will be nice, so I can sit back and relax and watch it until something goes horribly wrong, like the sound breaks or something like that.
No, it's fine. You've got professionals on the case. It's fine. They've got the, got an iPod. I don't know how this whole thing works. I'm on the side of the barrier. I'm quite happy to stay there. We were speaking about styles make fights. The next match I've got on this list, it's similar. It's similar in style. So this is kind of your two powerhouses going at it, which is a thing I love to see. I just love to see two, like, just slapping meat. I think that seems to be the cliche that goes around now. It's Luke Aldridge, don't call him Ostrich, Luke Aldridge against Brody Adler, Dynamite Brody Adler, big favourite when it comes to SWN, of course, which has done quite a few chats with us now. So this was one that intrigued me, because it is power-based, but Aldridge is quite a bit taller, quite a bit broader across the shoulders, maybe. It's still going to be a test for Brody.
Yes, and that was exactly the whole point. So Brody asked for a test. That's what she wanted. She wanted to be tested and pushed, because she wanted to be pushed further than what she's getting pushed. She feels like she needs that extra bit of push to get her to that next level of being a top star, which she already is at this point. She doesn't seem to realise that not many people make a big an impact as she has in such a short time. She's went from Source to Fair City, all the way up to Combat League, up north. I know there's other promotions interested. She competed for Fearsome Males and Renegade. That's five promotions in such a short period of time. So when she asked, "I want a challenge," I went, okay. And then I started to think to myself, what would happen if she was in with someone she couldn't necessarily throw around, that she couldn't outpower, or she wasn't the biggest in the ring? Just so happens, I was in contact with Luke Aldridge to bring him back into Source, as he's been in a few times. And he is also someone that's travelled over the country, improved slowly but surely. I remember young Luke Aldridge before Lucian Maynard Smythe. I remember that version. To see where he is now, it's completely night and day. So when she asked for a test, it just so happened that I was bringing Luke Aldridge in anyway, and it just kind of hit me. I was like, how would this match work? How would it play out? Who would win? Could Brody pick up and throw Aldridge? Could Aldridge throw Brody? And that's what intrigued me. It started to play in my mind. I was like, I'm definitely going to put this match together. So I went for it, and both of them were more than happy to accept the contest, which is, a lot of people don't really realize, but a lot of people have to agree to this stuff, and they were both very eager for the fight. So if they were happy to do it, let's do it.
I mean, yeah, were you saying you saw Luke Aldridge way before Lucian Maynard Smythe? I remember Luke Xavier when I started watching Scottish wrestling. So this is as of August, it'll be 10 years since I started going to wrestling shows in Scotland, which just makes me feel incredibly old when I'm seeing all these young talents come through, and you're saying they're 18. I'm thinking, oh God, they were 8.
I would be 10 years in the ring for me. This is my 10th year in the ring.
Well, weird kind of crossover of time. Yeah. So yeah, you're wrestling for a month when I started going to these shows. Weird how things work out. But no, so seeing Luke Xavier now we'll go to Lucian Maynard Smythe and go to Luke Aldridge. It's incredible. And every time I see him, when he comes up to W3L up in Elgin, or if I saw him in Bucky when UPW were about, he always adds something extra to his moveset. He's not just a power wrestler. I can easily say that.
Yeah, he always goes out of his way to improve. He never rests on what he's learned. He always wants to improve. He always tries to change. He always tries to adapt in some way. And I think that's just made him better than what he was. He's just improved massively, and that's why I was very happy to have him back. Not mentioning he's, I seem to be collecting six footers like their Pokemon cards here in Source, so that's another six footer I can add.
No, so there's not that many left, and I mean, there's a few up here, up in the northeast, but you're kind of collecting all the guys.
Right. Oh, I know.
I'm gonna guess there's a lot of guys. There's certainly a guy that's going around the country right now, just battering folk that I'm sure you've got an eye on. But a big Viking dude, the Norse god, I'm sure will probably make his way to Source at some point because he seems to be everywhere else. Yeah. Big Caleb Valhalla.
I remember wrestling him. That was a fun match.
Oh, was it up? Where did you end up? Where did you end up with Caleb Valhalla?
It wasn't Aberdeen, but it was WrestleZone. It was a Halloween hijinks, I think it was, or something like that. It was a very random thing that happened, and they were like, yeah, he's never really wrestled anyone outside of here. I went, okay, cool, great, I'm going to have fun with this. I looked at him and went, oh, you're going to throw me and I'm going to jump off of you. And it's one, I have the match and I'm very happy with it, and it was good. I very much enjoyed it.
I was thinking, I didn't want to like just go out and go, it was definitely WrestleZone because I thought it was, but I don't have the information in front of me. I don't want to just randomly say them he's definitely a guy that's making his way. I mean, this isn't a podcast, he's not on the show, so let's just move away. Sorry. This is just every podcast I do seems to either mention WrestleZone or mention Caleb Valhalla. I don't know how that's happened. It just seems to be that it happens. He's always on my mind somehow. I mean, look at him. Anyway, right. So, but Brody as well. Back on track here. Brody, yeah. who I've sung the praises of, because not just because of her in-ring talent, but also her attitude. I've said in numerous other podcasts, the difference between her and her first couple matches before pre-pandemic, and her attitude in ring talent now is just remarkable. She's become comfortable in her own skin, and she's been able to just embrace Brody Adler. And she's definitely not unfamiliar. She's familiar. That's double negative. She's definitely familiar with throwing guys about. Of course, that Fierce City, she's throwing about some Russian guys almost exclusively.
Yeah.
So Luke won't be the first massive guy that she's thrown.
she's also wrestled. She's wrestled. I believe she wrestled Scott McManus for Source in the past, and she has wrestled Griffin. I've done this in the past before. I don't care if you're a man, woman. If you're on my roster, you're a professional wrestler. I will book intergender because I don't care. Because I don't believe you should discriminate. Particularly in our sport, the difference between a man and a woman, there's no need, because I'm not being funny. The two of us, in this particular case, if I stood in the ring and Brody Adler stood in the ring, there's a very real chance you'd be more afraid of Brody than you would me. So, but at the same time, we have another woman on the roster, Cassie King, who absolutely terrifies me because she's a wee demon. Like
I'm hearing of this wee spooky woman. Going about and with Cassie King, of course, from popping up in Renegade as well. I haven't even seen her wrestle now, and I'm a little bit scared of her just because the reputation she's starting to garner here of just being spooky.
Yeah, she freaks me out. She another name confirmed for night one was Cassie King, but that's mostly because I was afraid to tell her no in case she killed me.
So there you go. We did say there was going to be surprises. Now, don't know who she's facing. Let's just keep that one
We'll keep that one a secret.
But Cassie King will be on night one as well, just to terrify you. So if you are going to come, which I'm sure you are, because again, I've already mentioned it's £5. Maybe just be careful. I suppose go for that.
Yeah.
like I say, this we went from Styles Clash, Styles Make Fights to just two powerhouses just leathering each other
a good heavyweight fight. That's what I love. I miss the day. I love stuff like when Hansen and Vader would fight because it was just chaotic and brawly, and it was just big dudes battering each other. And now we've got two big people just battering each other, because I imagine that's what's going to happen.
And this is really, again, we were mentioning in the first night, there's a lot of like just your classic kind of Source matches. This card, two matches that we've went through, this kind of showing the new hybrid that's coming of variety to Source Wrestling as well. The other match we've got, of course, is Grant McIver, who's a Source Wrestling champion since, you know what? Smart man would have had the information in front of him, but I'm not one of those guys. Since the 8th of November 2019, I've got here. He's been Source Wrestling champion. You can do the sums in your own head. I'm not doing it for you. So you can. It's a long time. He's held the title for a while now. And he's very cocky. We both know this. But yes, his promo work is absolutely sublime. The little documentary he put out for coming up to the show was just incredible work.
I wish he had told me about it beforehand, because my first experience of it was when he tagged the Source Wrestling Twitter in it, and I spent most of it just laughing at him. And I was like, I have no idea what he's talking about. But yes, he will be in action that night. For someone who was such just, I want to be a wrestler, I want to be the good, technically sound Dean Malenko-style wrestler that no one can compete with, and he is that, to suddenly, I think over lockdown, he's just went, let's just have a bit of fun. Because he was doing like his little Instagram things where he did one that was like a parody of the old school SmackDown versus Raw games, where it was like, oh, characters selected, and it was them bouncing, or maybe No Mercy. I can't remember what game it was.
I think it was No Mercy. I think he'll correct us, but I'm sure. Yeah. I think it was No Mercy.
But it was the changing of the attire and the classic stuff, and I just remember going, this is genius. This is great. Like, oh, it's just a shame he's so entitled.
But yeah, when he started, he wanted to be this Malenko guy. And even though he's one of his favorite wrestlers, he really is the Christian of Source Wrestling, Christian Cage, because he could do... I mean, that's not just because he's got a fantastic instant classic Christian Cage-style tracksuit, but...
That tracksuit in person is so much better than it is online, which is saying something. In person, it is miraculously gorgeous. And I was like, I love it.
But yeah, that's he's absolutely the perfect, I don't want to say utility, because if I say utility player, it sounds like he's just like, oh, you throw him in whenever. But if you've got a match on the card that has a space, or you need someone to go in and just absolutely entertain a crowd, put on an amazing match, I mean, you're hard pressed to find someone as good or better than Grant McIver.
Yes.
And like you're saying, when you're saying you wanted to be like the Malenko, that's how I kind of found, when I was watching his first couple of matches that went online, I was like, oh, he's a good wrestler. Not much personality, but he's a good wrestler. And then when you see things like one of the winter shows at Source, he came in and switched off the heating. It's just a little, again, that reminds me of that Christian Cage, just absolute dickery. You know, he's just one of those guys where you go, oh, you're a bit snide, but I kind of like you at the same time. But at the same time, you're a git.
Yeah, I saw him do it, and I just burst out laughing. And I was meant to be scouting him, because I was at that time the previous management was trying to schedule me and him for the title, and he did that, and I just burst out laughing. I went, I don't like wrestling, why? I like him too much.
I mean, like I said, there has been a big extended gap, which has made his title record look even better. But he really has carried the Source title with pride. Like I say, even though he is entitled and he's been, I'm trying to think of anything that doesn't swear, and I've already used dickery, and I think that's really just drawn like on the line a little bit. But he's just
the arrogance. He's arrogant. He's entitled. But at the end of the day, and this will be the point I sell to him, because he will no doubt complain that I didn't put him over enough. Grant McIver, for all his flaws, of all his entitlement, all his arrogance, and all of his pain in my backside as a boss, he is without a doubt one of the top wrestlers in the Source brand. There's a reason he's the champion. If we ignore, even if you ignore the fact that he had a two-year gap between his last defense against, which was LJ Cleary to Deren, in both those matches, he outperformed and outsmarted his opponent. He beat LJ Cleary. I'm pretty sure he made him tap out, and he made Deren tap out. For as much as I begrudgingly like him, I also do admit that he is one of the top talents Source has at the moment, and that's what made it so hard to give him an opponent, because I'm like, there are so many people that could have good matches with you and all have justifiable reasons to have this match. So, like the final boss of any good video game, you have to earn the right to fight Grant, because Grant is the champion and you have to earn that right, because by proxy of being that champion, he's the best in my company. And if you're going to fight the best in my company, which is Grant, you have to prove to me that you deserve to fight the final boss.
No doubt he's going to add the final boss to his
he's list of... final boss to his... You just see, I can hear Kwaku as he announces it, and he would now like to be introduced as the final boss. You'll just see me like this in the background.
That is absolutely happening, and I don't know. I'm assuming Grant's just going to steal it. he's not paying for that for those rights. But no, definitely he's again another guy who has been on the WWE Network, quite high profile, part of the manifesto as well. And he's not unfamiliar again with wrestling. He's wrestled a fair bit since even during lockdown, of course, of the closed door shows. So he's got a bit more experience. I mean, the guys that, of course, are in the first match, the four-way, have been able to get in the ring a bit elsewhere, whether it was the first Source show back, whether it was Respect, whether it was ICW as well. But I think probably out of all of them, I think Grant, out of the five here, I think four-way and Grant, he's probably had the most in-ring since coming back from this lockdown. So he's going to have a little bit more...
I'd say he's had some of the most high profile matches because his first match back from lockdown was Stevie Boy. Like, and I've talked about this, I think Stevie Boy is probably the best talent this country's ever produced. And Grant had an absolute excellent contest with him on the ICW Fight Club taping that they had on the WWE Network. I feel I just plugged that there. That was weird. But that contest showed that Grant hadn't been sitting on his backside for 2 years. He had continued to improve and he continued to learn. And he's part of the manifesto in ICW. I don't know what that's brought out to him for Source, but it's definitely made them a more well-rounded and seasoned performer. It's definitely helped him become the final boss.
And when we're talking about the manifesto, of course, in that four-way is ADM, who is the leader. I mean, not everything has to cross over in that, but it would be definitely interesting to see a rematch, a one-on-one match as well, with Grant McIver and ADM. All these guys definitely have earned the right to be in that four-way, but there's something very, very intriguing to see ADM and Grant McIver square off one-on-one with all the history that's just ongoing in Scottish wrestling with them as well. It would definitely be a sight to see.
Yep, definitely would, wouldn't it? Or, again, I don't know who's going to win that four-way, but I am very interested in seeing who fights Grant, because every one of them will have excellent contests with them. They've all got some form of history with Grant. Glenn the Bar was Grant McIver's debut. ADM, obviously, we can talk about it. Actually, I tell a lie, I think the only person that doesn't have any history with him is Dalen. I don't think Dalen have ever been in the ring, and I think Grant and Griffin have crossed paths once or twice, but never majorly. It's realistically just Dunbar, who was his debut. So I've completely contradicted myself, really.
We're saying, though, that four guys, Grant has got 24 hours-ish to prepare for four entirely different styles. Whether it's someone who's got this intensity that's going to just absolutely rip you apart limb from limb like Dalen, whether it's the Glenn Dunbar who's forgotten more than Grant probably knows, whether he wants to admit it or not. Griffin, again, and are very similar. Both sides of the same coin, I think, Griffin and Grant, where it comes to just sneakiness and then, of course, the terrifyingness of the Clyde River Killer, ADM. He's had to do a lot of homework since these matches were announced, or he's got 24 hours just to either get his affairs in order, perhaps, depending on who wins.
Yeah, but it's interesting. I can't wait to see what happens. Night two is just as action-packed as night one. The Working Man's Club will be in action on night two. Zero will be in action on night two, taking on a Source Wrestling debutee.
I don't envy the debutee if they're getting Zero.
Yeah, well, the debutee was quite cocky and confident, said he wanted a real challenge. I went, okay, Zero. I thought he would have backed down, but no, the trainee looked me dead in the eye, went, cool, and walked away. Very confident, very nonchalant, considering who Zero is, so I'll be pleasantly surprised to see what happens with that.
I mean, I don't think they do funerals on Sundays, but, you know, we might find out if Zero's in action with this young upstart. And the Working Men's Club, you said, of course, they'd be working hard. Of course, they're wrestling on Saturday because they'd be working 9 to 5 Monday to Friday. That makes sense. Is there going to be some trainees that are coming in against the Working Men's Club?
You'll have to wait to find that one out.
There you go. There's your tease. £5. Yeah. £5, please. You'll find out then at the time. So again, we'll recap the matches. So we've got Colton Davis versus Luke. No, we don't. I'm looking at the first night again. Switch tabs. Stone Malone versus Taylor Veit. This doesn't get edited out. You know me. I don't edit. Stone Malone versus Taylor Veit. Luke Aldridge versus Brody Adler. We know that Working Men's Club are going to be in action along with Zero as well. So again, if you thought you were going to be scared the first night with Cassie King, what can I tell you? Zero's going to be in night two. Then we've got Grant McIver defending the Source Wrestling Championship against the winner of the four-way from night one. Outside, again, doors open 6:30, bell time 7 p.m, available in the door, tickets, £5. Bar your own match, because I think it would be biased for you to say so. What would be the match? If you had to sell this whole weekend on one match, other than your own, what would it be?
Four-way for the top talents from Source, fighting for an opportunity to win. I'm technically selling on two matches, really, fighting for the right to fight the final boss. Like, that's just as old a story as wrestling is. You don't need complicated reasons. It's they all want to be champion. They have an opportunity to fight the champion, so they're going to fight as hard as they humanly can. You've got a legend. You've got a former champion. A determined underdog, and a man that feels he's been wronged for never being given an opportunity. So we've all got justifiable reasons, and they're all as hungry can be. So fatal four way. Yeah, I mean, personally, I'm really looking forward to Brody Adler versus Luke Aldridge, but that's just really my guilty pleasure, to be honest, because I want to see how that works.
I mean, like I said, there's so many great matches in store, and like, again, I'm stressing this £5 because you don't get wrestling for £5. That's just, it doesn't happen. Not a show with such established talents like your Grant McIvers, like your ADMs, like your Robbie Wisharts. You don't get that for £5. £5 is and not for right or wrong reasons, is your trainee shows. It's the guys that are just starting. This is their first kind of run out. You're getting. Getting Lucha DS, you're getting Brody Adler, you're getting Luke Aldridge, who's been around since for 10 years as well. You're getting experienced talent for £5 a night. It's just mind-boggling, the value that you're getting out of that. So yeah, Source Wrestling Resurgence. 18th of February, 19th of February. This will be coming out on Monday, so that means you've got like 5 days to organize what you're doing. You can get make sure the kids have nothing on the Friday. What are you gonna do on a Friday? Have a chippy? You can do that and then go to the wrestling. It's fine, you can do both. It's gonna be a wild night. A wild weekend, of course. Yes, there's two nights of wrestling, but I'm looking forward to watching. Of course, I'll be way up here in the sticks. We're sheep outnumber us, but I'll still be keeping an eye on YouTube and watching that four way as soon as it goes up. I'm looking forward to that. We went through the surprises. That obviously is not all. There's going to be other things, other people in store, I'm sure. Like you said, you're kind of gambling, putting all out six matches on your social media for a 14 match weekend. But the matches that you have announced, of course, are just absolute intrigue, interest, and it's worth the price of admission alone. Is there anything else you want to say to people if they're sitting on the fence after an hour and 20? We laughed about it being a 2-hour podcast, but we probably could do that if we wanted. But if anyone's still on the fence, what can you tell them?
You will be pleasantly surprised at what happens. For those who are fans of me, it'll be the last time you can see me in a Source Wrestling. For those who just enjoy a good night, that's what it is. It's a good fun night. If you don't want to come both nights, come to one night. Show support to. I know for £10, 14 matches, it's insane quantity for quality. It's insane. Don't know how many people pay that much and get essentially a Mania level card booking, but this is going to be my passion from now on. So if people are willing to support Source and willing to come and see that for £5, imagine what happens when I run outside of the school. Imagine what happens when the next time I talk to yourself about a Source Wrestling show, I talk about some of the other surprises I have in store for this year. If this is what I'm going to do with the rest of my time, you know, as a professional wrestler, I'm going to be proud of it. I'm going to make Source a company that people are going to be excited when they announce a show.
So if people want to find out more about the show or anything else, of course, we've already given you the scoops because that's what we do here at SWN. But you can go to facebook.com/ScottRez. That's mine, ScottResNet. But you can go to facebook.com/SourceRez if you want as well. And you can find out more about Source Wrestling. I'm assuming it's the same on Twitter, but I'm going to find out because that's what professionals do. Source. I'm saying this like you don't know what the thing for Source Wrestling is, but it is at Source Res as well on Twitter. So any match
I'm just enjoying watching you try to remember it.
I know. It's always the case where we're doing these previews. I think I'll get all the information I need in front of me. I won't need anything else. And then as soon as it starts, I go, I need this as well. Oh no. Then everyone who can watch this can see when I'm switching tabs because the light changes on my face going, why did I make my website just so white? That's what I'm kind of regretting now. Because you can just see me just switching tabs and my face just lights up like a moon. Anyway, right. So this is the portion where we just kind of steer off into absolute randomness. But like I say, £5 each night, £10 in total, amazing matches. Listen back to the start of this podcast where we actually talked about the wrestling and the matches. And now we're just kind of spinning off into nonsense. But I can't wait to see the results. Can't wait to see the shows on YouTube. Yeah, there's not much more we can say. So yeah, go to the door on Friday. Can you get tickets for both nights on the Friday, or do you have to go Saturday?
On Friday when you arrive. If you want to buy a ticket for both nights, it'll be £10, and we'll take your name, and as soon as you arrive at the door, we'll guide you to your seat.
Wonderful. Perfect. Well, thank you very much for joining me. I think that's as much as we can we can absolutely hype the show up, and I think we've done so. But if you're still unsure, at Source Res, I'm sure the guys there will give you all the information you require. I'm assuming there's like usual. You recommend lap flow tests and all that kind of jazz.
Always, yes. Yeah. Yes. So please take a lap flow before you arrive. Please be willing to provide results if we ask, and of course, please just take care.
That's a nice way to end it. We'll end it with that then.
Yeah, I think so.